In the mighty name of Jesus, I cover you with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We are looking at tonight the message that I have titled, Grace to Please God. Grace to Please God. Everyone that God has made, in fact, God made us for His pleasure. He made us for His purpose. He made us to please Him. So when we are not pleasing Him, we are not doing the right thing. And if you look through the scripture, most of the times that God punished the children of Israel, it was due to the fact that they disobeyed Him. It was due to the fact that they refused to please Him. It was due to the fact that sometimes they go after other gods. It was due to the fact that sometimes they misbehave. It was due to the fact that sometimes they don't even call upon God that had delivered them from the hand of Pharaoh in the land of bondage in Egypt. So when they displease God, things go against them. The same thing happens these days. When human, displease God, God will be angry. And the Bible says it is a thing to fall into the hand of the angry God. I pray that the Lord will not be angry with you. The Lord will not be angry with me. But what I am saying today is that we should try as much as possible to please God in all our ways. What are the things we are doing that we can say, yes, I know I am not pleasing God. I love what the Bible says concerning Enoch. I read from the book of Hebrews chapter 15, chapter 11 rather, from verse 5. Hebrews 11, 5. It says, by faith, Enoch was translated that he should not see death, and he was not found because God had translated him. Why? Say, for before his translation, he had this testimony. Is a testimony that he does what? He pleased God. Before Enoch was taken away, can you imagine that kind of pleasing, pleasure he made to God, how he referenced God, how he pleased God, to the extent that God said, this one, I will not allow you to die. I will take you. Can you imagine that kind of translation? God translated him. God took Enoch. He did not allow him to see death. Why? He pleased God. He pleased God. He pleased God. Doing the bidding of God sometimes, especially when it does not go with what you desire, sometimes is very, very difficult. But in pleasing Him lies our blessing. If you check the whole of the Bible, every blessing comes with conditions. 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 Do this and I will do this. If you do this, I will do that. And the Lord was blessing His people. The Lord was honoring His people. Look at Abraham. Look at Abraham. Today we say we are children of Abraham. But Abraham, God told him, leave your father's house, and he obeyed. Not only that, God told him, go and slaughter your son, and he obeyed. God, you know, was so happy with Abraham. God was so pleased with Abraham. Can we say God is pleased with us? What is happening? Can you say of a truth, God loves everything I am doing? If there is anything we are doing that God does not love, we should try as much as possible to forsake it so that the Lord can bless us more. And I'm praying that the Lord will bless you, will bless your generation even more than your expectation in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Genesis, Genesis chapter 15, verse 6, it says, "And Abraham believed the Lord, and it was counted unto him for righteousness." Abraham believed God. The same thing is written in the book of Romans chapter 4, verse 3. "For what saith the scripture? Abraham believed God, and it was counted unto him for righteousness." So it is not by the works, It is just that Abraham believed God. It is not that Abraham was outrightly righteous. Let me put it that way. But because he believed God. He believed God when he asked him to leave where he was. Leave your father's house. He left. Go and slaughter your son. He believed God that he is able to raise another son for him. Abraham believed God. In another way, you can say Abraham pleased God. Can you please God? Or are we pleasing God? We have to try as much as possible to please God. No wonder the Bible says in the book of Proverbs chapter 16 verse 7. Proverbs 16, 7. It says, "When a man's way please the Lord, he makes even his enemy to be with peace with him." When our ways please the Lord, he will make even the enemies, the adversaries, the people that we think, they just want to see our downfall. He will make them, he will force them to be in peace with us. What is scripture? When a man's way please the Lord. When a man's way please the Lord. The truth is, if our way pleases the Lord, it will make so many things to work in our favor. See what the book of Isaiah, chapter 1, verse 19 says. It said, "If you be willing and obedient, you shall eat the fruit of the Lord, of the land, rather. Ye shall eat the good of the land, if ye be willing." It means if we are willing to please God, if we are willing to obey him as Abraham did, if we are willing to please God, we are going to eat the good of this land. We must be able to please God in all things. Let us strive to do that. It is very, very, very important. Don't look at what is happening around you. Don't look at the corruption that is happening around you. Don't look at the pollution, the vices that is going on around you. Don't join them. Let them join you. That says that if you can't beat them, you join them. No. A child of God does not join a bad thing. You must be the light. The Bible says you are the light of the world. The light, a city that is established upon the housetop, say it cannot be hidden. You can never join darkness. You cannot join the people that are displeasing God. The Bible says, "And you, the light, say you shine in darkness, and darkness cannot comprehend it." You must be a light wherever you find yourself. The Lord is calling unto you, just like I said on Sunday. He said, "Come unto me, come unto me." That was the message on Sunday. And the Lord is calling unto us. We have to please God. Whenever the children of Israel please God, the Lord will send help to them. Even the enemies that had earlier defeated them, God will cause those enemies to be smitten before them. The same thing goes to you. If you try as much as possible to please God, the power that thinks that thoughts that they have defeated you, that thoughts that they have had a field day in your life, God will reverse the situation. God will reverse it and will make you to be a winner. Will make you to be victorious. It is very, very important. It is very, very, very important that we please God. And the grace to please God, the Lord will release upon us. The book of John, chapter 6, verse 63. It says this, very, very profound scripture. It says, it is the spirit that quickeneth. Or in the modern English, it is the spirit that quickens. The flesh profits nothing. The flesh profits nothing. It is the flesh that will not allow us to please God. Hey, you need to read your Bible. Have you read your Bible today? How many chapters did you read? I used to tell people, when you want to cultivate the habit of reading scripture, take it gradually. But ensure that you are actually meditating, not just reading. And before you know it, the Lord will help you to do better. I want you to know that you must try as much as possible to please God. Say, the flesh, it is the spirit that quickens, the flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak to you, they are spirit and they are life. The word you are hearing now, it is spirit, it is life. And don't forget, Jesus is that spirit. Jesus is that life. He has given you life in abundance. The breath you are breathing, it is the gift of God. And God has kept you alive to do His bidding. God has kept you alive to please Him. God has kept you alive to do His pleasure. But the question is, are we doing it or we are doing what we want? Whenever the children of Israel do what God does not like, He punished them. Whenever they please God, He will make sure that he turned again their captivity. He was the one that made them to be taken away captive. But that same God, because don't forget, He's the Alpha and Omega. He's the Almighty God. He will turn it again and make it to favor them. Whatever you are passing through, God is able to turn it around in your favor. If only you will seek Him, if only you will please Him. The book of 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 8a says, and God is able, this is the scripture for you tonight, and God is able to make all grace abound towards you. Grace to please God, grace to prosper, grace to make it, grace to make heaven at last, because it is going to be by grace, not by work. Grace to make heaven at last. Grace to be victorious. Grace to have to be fulfilled in life. Say, and God is able. Our God is able. If we can please Him, God is able to make all grace abound towards you. That you, look at what it says, that you always having all sufficiency in all things. Having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. When you please God, you will have all sufficiency in all things. You will have everything in abundance. Don't forget, the scripture says in book of Psalm 24, it says, the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. You will have all sufficiency if you can able to please God. The grace to please God, the Lord will release upon you. When you please God, He will work for your good. When you please God, He will work for your good. When you please God, He will not allow the enemy to overcome you. When you please God, He will even force your enemy to live in peace with you. When you please God, you will be able to make heaven at last. When you please God, God will bless you and take over your battles. I love that. When you please God, God will bless you, then He will take over your battles. Your enemies become the enemies of God. Your friends become the friends of God. Whoever that curses you, just like God told Abraham, he is cursed. Whoever that blesses you is blessed. That is what happens when you please God. So it is more beneficial to please God than to displease Him. I am praying for somebody. In that situation, the Lord will give you grace to please him. In that particular decision you need to make, the Lord will help you to please him. The Lord will help you to please him in the name of Jesus. And I wrap up with this scripture. Proverbs chapter 16. Proverbs chapter 16, I read verses 8 and 9. Say, better is a little with righteousness than great revenue without right. Better is a little with righteousness. You have peace of mind with the little that you have than when you have great revenue and you are displeasing God with it. Verse 9 says, a man's heart devises his ways, but the Lord directs his step. A man's heart devises his way, but the Lord directs his step. When you please God, God will direct your step to the right place at the right time, meeting the right people, saying the right words, and having right results. And everything about you will be right. I am praying for you tonight that the grace to please God in all things, not just in a particular area of life, the Lord will give to you. This kind of message, people does not want to listen to it again because it is contrary to what they want. It is not what they want because some people just want sweet words. But let me tell you, if you do everything and you are not hearing sound teachings, you are not hearing sound words, you are not yielding, even if you hear it and you are not yielding to it, it will not profit you. And at the end of the day, everyone will stand before the throne of God to give account of what he has done with his life. Nobody will have excuse on that day. Jesus may come at any time. How will he meet you? Are you ready? But I can tell you, if you are pleasing him, if you are obeying him in every step of the way, and he's leading you, he's directing you, I tell you, heaven is your place. Paradise is waiting for you. And at the end of the day, you will make it to heaven. You will not be lost. You will not be wasted. And I want to say this, hellfire is not made for human beings. Hellfire is made for the devil and his agent. So it is a costly mistake to go to hellfire and to think that somebody wants to go to where was made for the devil. God has prepared a place for us. Say, eyes have not seen, neither has it come to the heart of man, what God has prepared for those people that love him. Are you willing to please God in all things? That is why you need that grace. It is not by power, it is not by might. You need that grace. That is why we read that 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 8, that says God is able to make all grace abound towards you. That grace you are going to receive now in the name of Jesus. The first thing I want you to do is to begin to tell God, Father, have mercy on me. In any way I've not been pleasing you, in any way I have been disobeying you, in any way I have been doing my own will instead of doing yours, Father, forgive me. Please sincerely pray to God and ask for forgiveness. Thank you, Jesus. Father, have mercy. Father, have mercy. Father, have mercy. Father, have mercy. Forgive, Lord. Forgive, Lord. Forgive, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. There are 5 prayers I want you to pray tonight before we go to bed. And the first prayer is the title of the message, Grace to Please God. Grace to Please God. You are going to say it loud and clear. Say, I receive the grace to please God in every area of my life. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. I receive the grace to please God in every area of my life. Oh yes, receive the grace. 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 Receive the grace to please God in every area of your life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The scripture says in the book of 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10, say, and the God of all grace, who hath called you unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, say, after that ye have suffered for a while, we strengthen you, we establish you, we perfect you, and he will settle you. It is that settlement that I want you to ask for tonight. I want you to ask for that settlement. Say, the God of all grace. God of all grace can settle you. I want you to pray. Say, God of all grace, arise for my sake and settle me in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth. Tell God the area you want him to settle you. Settle me concerning my career. Settle me concerning my marriage. Settle me concerning my finances. Settle me concerning my business. Father, settle everyone connected. Every family represented on this prayer altar. Everyone under the sound of my voice. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, Father. The Lord wants to heal somebody. If you are sick in any part of your body, just lay your right hand on that place. Lay your right hand. If you have any sickness on any part of your body, Holy Spirit, I am praying for this particular person you want to heal. Holy Spirit, by the stripe of Jesus, let this person receive healing right now. In the name of Jesus, by the healing virtue, let this person receive healing right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree upon your life, be healed in your body, be healed in your arteries, be healed in your bones, be healed in your womb, be healed in every part of your body in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the healing virtue of God come upon you now in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' name we pray. There is somebody on this prayer platform. There is a particular thing you want God to do for you before the end of this month. I'm not talking about next month. This month of July. There is a particular thing you want God to do for you. Please, I want you to mention that thing 7 times to God. Just mention it 7 times. Pakia de Boshina Takaidaba. Lord, I am praying for this particular person. As this person has mentioned that thing 7 times, which represents perfection. Therefore, Father, in this month of perfection, perfect that testimony. Perfect that testimony. That testimony. It doesn't matter how big your request is. Let the God that is bigger than your request answer you now in the name of Jesus. Concerning that request, as you have said in the hearings of God, it has become a testimony. The Lord will do unto you as you have said. I join my faith with your own and I decree by the power that calleth those things that do not exist as if they were, I call forth that your testimony. Let it become testimony this month by the mercy of God. Thank you, Father. Jesus' mighty name we pray. Very quickly, we have 2 more prayers to pray. You are going to pray. Say, and the God, say, God is able to make all grace abound towards you. There are levels of grace. There are different types of grace. There are graces that attract favor. There are graces that bring prosperity. There are graces that bring you know, a long life. There are graces that bring sweatless, you know, achievement. I want you to pray. Say, God, arise and let all grace abound towards me. That is a prayer. Oh God, arise and let all grace abound towards me. You begin to mention it, grace to prosper,
grace to please you, grace to be favored, grace for long life, grace for good health. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Oh God, arise, let all grace abound towards everyone under the sound of my voice. Let all grace abound. Let all grace abound. Let all grace abound so that they can have sufficiency in everything. Let all grace abound towards them. Grace to excel. Grace to prosper. Grace to be victorious. Grace to make it. Grace to please God. Grace to be fulfilled. Grace to make heaven at last. Receive grace. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I am praying for this person. I am praying for this person that there is spirit of untimely death in your family. And it looks as if you yourself, you are exercising the, you are having the thoughts of death, thoughts of death. The Bible says, you shall not die but live, to declare the works of the Lord in the land of the living. Therefore, I decree, by the power of he that died and lives, by the power of resurrection, every curse of death over the life of anyone under the sound of my voice is cancelled now in the name of Jesus. Anyone that is counting days for you, that you will soon give up the ghost, I decree they will count in vain, because you shall not die but live to declare the works of the Lord in the land of the living. I cover you the blood of Jesus. The blood that speaketh the better things than the blood of Abel. Let it speak healing, deliverance, wholeness upon your life. And every sickness unto death, I curse you to die. Let this one go in the mighty name of Jesus. I cover you the blood of Jesus. It is not your turn to die, but it is your turn to testify. It is your turn to move forward. Every spirit of death, every thought of death, I cast it. I cast it out of your life in the name of Jesus. It is well with you. Let the presence of God, let the glory of God overshadow your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. No evil thoughts will come to pass in your life in Jesus' mighty name. This is the last prayer because of our time. You are going to decree. This one is a decree. This one is a decree. Say, I decree, let life be easy for me. Aha. Yes. Yes. Let life be easy for me. So many people, life is so hard for them. To achieve any little success, they have to do everything in a hard way. You are going to pray for yourself. Say, I decree. Don't forget, the Bible says you shall decree a thing, and it shall be established, and light shall shine on your path. Say, I decree, let life be easy for me from tonight. Open your mouth and begin to say, it's a decree. Oh yes, I decree, let life be easy for me. Let career be easy for me. Let finances be easy for me. Oh yes, let every area of life. Oh yes, yes, receive the anointing of ease. Receive the grace to achieve things with his. Receive the grace to achieve things with his. Receive the grace to achieve great things with his. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. Let the presence of God go with you. Let the glory of God overshadow you. As you go to bed, the Lord will minister to you. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Anyone that will call your name for evil tonight, thunder and earthquake shall swallow them in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will be with you. The glory of God will not depart from you. His presence will never leave you in the name of Jesus. You will sleep in peace. You will have victorious dream and wake up in peace in the mighty name of Jesus. See you on Sunday.
God will never fail you. No matter what you're going through, He will surely see you through. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.